Yeah.
Way easier to get amateur kickboxing. Once you go pro, you don't have that option anymore.
Yeah.
You know, it might be hard to find kickboxing fights as a professional, especially if you got a lot of wins as a mixed martial artist.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following bantamweight kickboxing bout is brought to you by Team Meals, set with 3 2-minute rounds of action. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this Muay Thai style fighter stands at 5 feet 6 inches tall. He weighed in at 134.4 pounds. He enters this fight with a record of 0 wins and 1 loss. And fighting out of Kyokuyama Fighting Gym in Little Havana, Florida, he is Kelvis Machado. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, this mixed martial artist stands at 5 feet 6 inches tall. He weighed in at 135 pounds. He enters this fight making his amateur kickboxing debut and fighting out of the Combat Club and West Palm Beach, Florida. He is David Martinez.
And I dare you to fight a better looking man than Rodney Brewer in the corner of Damian Martinez. Just kidding. That'd be so easy. First kickboxing bout of the evening, Shorty. I am hyped.
Now, no more slaps. All no. Closed hands. These guys are going to go at it.
Now, round number one of our first kickboxing bout underway. And a head kick off the bat for Martinez.
Hey, you got to start the night off strong. Beautiful team kicks.
Mm-hmm. Woo!
These guys immediately going at it. No feel-out process.
Mm-mm.
Wow.
Wow. Look out, Wesley Golden. Our referee's in trouble in there. He's going to get ran over.
Yeah.
Nice right hand and a little slip there. Good right hand.
Talking about refereeing, you had to move a while too. You had to move a while. I was like, man, you're getting your own little workout.
I love it. A lot of wrestling.
Man, these guys are both just aggressive.
Yep, they will have, I heard. Oh, nice right hand from Martinez.
They're going in for that Superman punch. And I like that Machado's not just, throwing nothing but haymakers. He's mixing it up to the head, to the body, going down to the legs.
Yeah, I always appreciate the guy, too, Shorty, coming from a wrestling background like you, that controls the center of the mat and works forward to the outside.
I just love action, you know.
There's a lot of action out of Machado there.
Oh.
Another slip by Martinez.
That's how hard he's kicking, a swing and a miss, and he goes down.
Good body kick.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful knees.
You heard during the rules meeting, same as I did, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi break, right? 3 seconds in the clinch. No, another head kick.
Just going in, but look how Machado's just walking forward, stopping his opponent, looking like a Muay Thai stance, just walking in. Scary. It's like the bad guy from the Kickboxer.
Tong Po. According to his shorts, he's a Muay Thai addict.
Just walking
forward. Good leg kick, too. Nice body work there.
I'm telling you, he's just mixing it up.
Leg kick upstairs, end of the round. Wow, that was a lot of action in 2 minutes.
And a beautiful outside leg kick to end it.
So now it's time for the part that we all hate as commentators. Who you give that round to, Shorty?
Oh, man, for me, I'm going to give it to Machado. He kept the center of the cage more. He was a lot more active. And just overall in general, I'm a fan of him mixing it up. Head to the body, to down to the legs, and just overall that pressure of walking forward. And again, he reminds me of the evil guy from the Kickboxer, so I automatically go for him.
There you go. Yeah, I would certainly say that Machado did the better work, same as you for sure. Not to say that Martinez did not land some nice shots. I love the aggression with the opening head kick and several more head kicks. But I also feel that Machado did the better work here. Interesting to see what adjustments are made in between rounds.
Yeah, for Martinez, he threw those head kicks, and maybe they didn't land, but he's showing that he can get the leg up there. He's showing that he's trying to knock his opponent out, and he's trying to do something different, but he needs to set those up coming into the next round to keep Machado on his heels instead of walking forward the entire time.
Yes, indeed. Got to give your opponent something to respect. Round number two underway. Kelvis Machado, Damian Martinez, opening kickboxing bout of the evening here at XFN 35. joining us worldwide on Flow Combat. Yeah, that's Shorty Torres you're hearing, by the way.
You see Martinez pulling out that jab.
Good right hand.
Blitz right hand. Just pulling out that jab, and he's not standing in front of Machado this time, which is a huge thing.
Good adjustments. Championships are won between rounds. Ooh. Good body work, though. Man, I love the work from Machado here on the wall.
Martinez is having a better game plan. He's not standing in front, and he's moving more. Mm. Anytime he stands in front, Machado just pushes him against the fence, is able to land those leg kicks, and you see that pressure walking forward. It's exhausting to be on your heels.
Very hard to kick against that, yeah, when you're backing up.
And plus, you just have no power. It's very rare to land that knockout blow going backwards.
Yes,
not everyone is an Anderson Silva versus Forrest Griffin.
That's correct. Not, in fact, almost nobody. Or Melvin Manhoef, Mark Hunt.
Yeah. And again, trying again for that head kick.
What I'd give to be half the Manhoef Melvin is. Oh, nice work again from Machado.
I just wish I was as tall as him, but, you know, whatever.
Well, I certainly would not make any jokes involving your stature, Mr. Torres. Takes all weight classes, my friend.
I was like, we're only the same size right now because I'm sitting on a high chair. I know everyone can't see it, but it helps. It really does help.
Sitting in Santa's lap. Machado still on that stalk. Good angle off there by Martinez, though, finally. Not back into the cage. When he backs to the cage, he's taking a lot of punishment, to Machado's credit.
And Machado, he's walking forward. He's able to get that outside leg kick, which is a beautiful job. Oh. I think it was an accidental groin shot. Again, one leg went up. That stuff does happen when two people are kicking at the same time.
Yes, it
does. Especially in opposite stances.
Yeah, Martinez has switched stances there as well. I think that Machado, I like the most is making Martinez pay for backing up to the cage. Every time Martinez plants on the cage for half a second, four, five, six shots from Machado, and that's been the most impressive work I've seen from this fight today.
I feel like I have to be fair now. You know, like, This second round was a lot closer than the first.
Absolutely.
Martinez changed his game plan. But for you now, who do you believe won the second round?
Well, this is the part where I go, thank God we're not a judge. 10-10s are a thing. I feel like both guys did a lot of work, maybe more output from Machado. But, again, a lot of adjustments made between rounds, as you said, out of the Combat Club corner there for Martinez. I wasn't scoring it. I don't know. 10-10.
I could see it going a very even.
How's that for a cop out?
Yeah, it was a very even round. I might give it to Machado because of that pressure.
Yep.
Martinez, he landed some really good shots, but Machado was able to push him against the fence, land his combinations, and just implement his will. And it's a hard thing. But going into this third and final round, right?
Yes, sir.
Going into this third and final round, is Machado going to keep on walking forward and putting the pressure like he is now?
Triple right hook from Machado there.
See that little dirty box in there?
I did. 3-second clinch. Do whatever you want with it, they said.
Hey, I'm a Mexican brawler.
Nice.
I'm perfectly fine with that dirty boxing.
Yeah, it's certainly been a highlight of yours for sure. And it has been a highlight for Martinez and Machado there, both getting it inside. Maybe one too many times to the well with a Superman punch for Martinez. Machado seems to be figuring that out. Now, to what you were saying between rounds, I think maybe the flurry, the combinations on the cage for Machado are scoring better. They're leaving more of a memory. Does that make sense?
Ooh, nice spinning back. Caught him flush. But Martinez keeps on blitzing in.
Yep.
But he's not setting it up, and he's missing, and it's exhausting.
That is correct. Maybe you have to assume he knows he's down, or he thinks he's down two rounds to none. And he feels like he needs to do something big here, but you got to land. Exactly. Beautiful point.
And that's a fair guesstimate, too. You might be down two rounds and none.
Yep. But you're not going to win blitzing and missing, as you pointed out. He does need to start making better contact. Does Martinez. Nice left hand down the pipe there from Machado.
And Machado just walking forward, man.
Yeah.
He does not care.
No breathing room for Martinez. Martinez, to his credit, has taken Machado's best shots, which have been pretty good. And has shown no real
kick.
Yeah, very good varied attack there from Machado. Inside, outside, leg, body, head, making the Christmas tree on Martinez. Good body work there from Martinez.
Yep. I mean, when you got an opponent that's square like Machado, those body shots are there. It's just scary to walk forward because you might run into a knee. You might take some late kicks.
Mm-hmm. Like that. Nice jab from Martinez as well. I'd like to see him done that more in the first two rounds. finally lands that Pettis punch.
And that was awesome. That was right off the cage, too. Machado chest bumping, ready to go.
That is it. Wow. 3 minutes of pretty much so nonstop action, Shorty.
I mean, for the first kickboxing fight of the day, that's a good start.
Yeah, we have a tradition here at XFN. The first fight of the night is always fireworks. Now, we reserve that for mixed martial arts fights, but these kickboxers tonight were holding themselves true to the standard.
Hey, man, they're coming off strong, and I like this. These guys were both game, both putting the pressure. But Machado, man, he's the evil guy from Kickboxer. He's walking forward. He's scary, implemented his will. Martinez, this is a very, very good learning experience for him. If you have an opponent who just walks forward like Machado, who does not stop and is a great aggressive counter fighter, it's something to think about moving into your next competition.
Yep, focus on now the angling out, striking on the angle out, and not getting pressure to the cage. We will hand it over to our boy Blake Chadwick to make this official. Where is Blake Chadwick? He's hiding?
We're waiting for the scorecards? I think he's waiting for the scorecards.
Oh, Blake Chadwick is collecting the scorecards. He's doing super duty tonight. I said duty.
Yeah.
Tens and nines never been so hard to arithmeticize.
Yeah, I was about to say, usually when it takes so long, it's like, is there a split decision on the way?
Perhaps, yeah, because scorecards are rendered after each round. It's not they're scoring the whole fight. It's just how'd you score the third round? Add them up, tens and nines. There's our guy, Blake Chadwick. Hey, Blake, tell us who won the bouts. There, buddy, the bouch.
Bleak.
Uh-oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scores. All three judges ruled this fight 30-29. Your winner, the unanimous decision, out of the blue corner, Galvis Machado!
30-29. Looks like I wasn't the only person saying 10-10 in that middle round.
Yeah.
And another round, apparently, as well.
Yeah. It was a much closer fight than we thought.
Yeah. Yeah, I kind of felt like I had Machado taking it.